Hey there, Head Squeezers. Hope you're well. So the Head Squeeze channel has reached 250,000 subscribers. That's 250,000. All down to you guys who have subscribed. Thank you so, so much. It means the world to all of us here on the Head Squeeze channel. Everyone works so, so hard to bring you these films. So thank you so, so much. To celebrate, we have got a week full of videos, all connected to the number 250K. My question is, how can a burger cost £250,000? Yes, we are going pounds with this one, not dollars. Sorry to anyone across the pond. Now, this is the world's first synthetic burger. It was made in Maastricht University. Now, how they did it was they extracted stem cells from biopsies taken from two cows, a Belgian blue and the other a blonde d'Aquitaine. These cells were then used to grow up 20,000 muscle fibers. Essentially, each one is a little loop of protein, kind of grey-white protein, floating in a gel of antibiotics and a special kind of serum. Getting peckish yet? Anyway, stick with me. What the scientists then did is they pulled out each of these hoops, they cut them open, they straightened them out, they jammed them all together. Then they essentially put on their chef's hat. They combined a bit of saffron, breadcrumbs, beetroot for the colour, and loads of binding ingredients, and voila, the first lab-made burger. Now, the £250,000 price tag was put up by Google co-founder Sergey Brin. Thanks very much for that. It wasn't exactly fast food, though. It took 3 months to create the burger, so it may be waiting a little while. But why do it at all? Why do it? Well, by the year 2060, it's estimated that the Earth's population will reach a staggering 9.5 billion people. And that may indeed double our meat requirements. Scientists are concerned because it's going to cause a huge peak in our carbon dioxide and methane emissions. Also, the livestock farming may well account for half, a whopping half, of all the emissions you're going to get from automobiles, from aeroplanes, from trucks. That's incredible. But most importantly, what did it taste like? Well, if you ask the lucky samplers, they say it tasted pretty much like meat. One said it was like an animal protein cake. But keep in mind, this is just the first phase. It's essentially just pure protein at this stage. What they want to do is grow some lab-made fat cells, put that in for that characteristic burgery taste. What do you guys think? Maybe sometime in the future, after a night out in the pub, you will be queuing at your local lab for your burger, not down at the chippy van. What do you reckon? Let me know in the comments below this one. That's all the time I've got for right now. Next week, normal service will resume, so send me in your favourite questions that have got you scratching your head and I'll pick out my favourites. Click here if you want to see my favourite videos from the Head Squeeze channel so far. Thanks again to all of you who have subscribed. It really does mean a lot. And until next time, happy head squeezing.